Welcome everyone to this week's episode of Unrooted Men's Basketball Edition. And my guest for this week's show is none other than junior guard on the men's basketball team here at Menlo College, Jared Wall. Jared, thanks so much for joining me on the show.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Brian.
You're very welcome. Let's start by talking a little bit about yourself. Now, I'm glad I finally have you on the show because I've been meaning to ask you for a long time now. Do people actually mistake you for Andy Dalton?
Yes, they do. It was a lot more evident. Sorry, it's getting a little hot in here. It was a lot more evident back when I was, in high school and had more of a clean look. But, people do still tend to mistake me for Andy Dalton, especially around Halloween time. So,
Now, you were saying you've been Andy Dalton twice for Halloween here at Menlo College?
Twice. I got the jersey on eBay for like $15, and it's about the easiest, easiest, other than Archie from Riverdale, it's about the easiest costume I can, come up with, so.
But now the big question is, how long are you going to let the hair flow? Because the longer it gets, the less you look like Andy Dalton.
Yeah, so I've been growing my hair out for about a year, and I told my mom that I would cut it once I went in for an interview, so I guess it's about time I cut it, right, Mom?
That's true.
She meant a job interview, but I guess this counts too, so we'll see.
It kind of does. Well, don't worry, mother of Justin Wall or Jared Wall, I'm not going to actually cut his hair live on the show.
Well, that'd be fun, wouldn't it?
That's an interesting idea. Yeah. Maybe like an end of the season bonus episode.
Definitely.
That would be kind of funny. How does the girlfriend feel about it?
She likes it. Let me rephrase that.
No.
She doesn't not like it. That's what I've been told. So I'm, until she doesn't like it, then, I'll let it go. So
that's a good way to look at it. So you're a smart man. Now, it's no secret that you also play with the most visible energy out of any men's basketball player on the team. Where do you get all this energy and the passion for the game from?
It started when I was really young. I never really wanted to be outworked on the court. I played a bunch of different sports. I played football, baseball, basketball, and actually I tried lacrosse out one time. But I've never been the best at the sport, but I've always been the hardest worker or wanted to be the hardest worker. And so I figured that, if I just play as hard as I possibly can, no matter if we win or lose, I can live with myself,
And it certainly shows with the way you carry yourself on the court. Now let's talk about the team here a little bit. Menlo got the ball rolling last week. First conference win of the season, 87-75 over San Diego Christian. What really clicked that helped you guys put it all together?
Yeah, so we had a team meeting the day before the game, and it was held by Najai LeBlanc on the team and Corey LaPepe, and they just wanted us all to have the opportunity to talk about, to kind of collectively get back together and start talking about what we need to do to get that first conference win. We were so close in so many games, and we had a couple of young guys that were stepping up and taking to themselves to get us back on track, and it was really good to see. I think a lot of guys really saw that as kind of a wake up call for the team, and so that got us going back on the right track. And we just, it's playing 40 minutes, not just playing 20, not playing 39. It's playing 40 full minutes of basketball, and I think we did that against San Diego Christian.
You were nearly able to pull that off against 15th ranked Vanguard as well. You led for 36 minutes in the game, but the Lions came back 1-2. Jeremiah Testa last week on the show said that the Oaks can beat anybody. Do you have the same thoughts? Do you think the Oaks can, in fact, beat anybody? Because you almost beat Vanguard.
Sure. I mean, since I've been here at Menlo College, I've just been with a lot of guys that want to play, a really good group of guys that just really, if we put anything we put our minds to, we can accomplish. And I don't think that there's a single team in the NAIA that we can't beat, and I don't think there's a single team in the NCAA that we can't beat. We led several times in the Cal Poly game that we played against a Division I team. We played Long Beach State, and we're very close at halftime within 3 points. I really think that we can beat any team we put our minds to. It's just if we're all putting it towards the same goal, I think we can accomplish great things.
One guy who's been really energetic as of late, Henry Cornelius. He's had some huge dunks, including the one he went coast to coast to on Thursday night. What's been the cause of his career best season?
Yeah, well, I had a phone call with Henry a couple days ago, and I was just talking to him about, after we got the win, I was talking to him about how he's feeling and everything, and he is the biggest heart on the team. He loves every single person on our team and cares for us so much, and I think that he's also very smart, and when he uses the heart and his also his smarts in the game, it helps get him into just almost this unconscious play where he's just, he's got such, you know, a level of energy. And And I think, you know, he's one of the veterans on our team. He's been, he's a senior, you know, one of two. And he's just, I think, really doesn't want to go out without helping us reach our potential, you know.
Yeah. Now Menlo hits the road this week. You'll certainly be challenged on Saturday against an Arizona Christian team that's ranked 25th or ranked in the top 25 in the NAIA. They're a much improved squad. So what's going to be the key to taking them down this weekend?
Yeah, honestly, I mean, just knowing all their guys, they've got some returners that are going to be a challenge for us, but there's not a single guy on that team we can't guard. Just knowing what they do best and not allowing, making them do something else. And also, I mean, just sticking to our game plan, you know. I don't think that we don't need to change our game plan for other teams. We just need to execute our game plan to the best of our ability. And again, I think we can beat any team, including Arizona Christian, to start off the road trip.
And I think it was your freshman year when Menlo beat Arizona Christian when they were ranked number 10 in the country.
I think so.
It was either your freshman year or the year before you came in.
Yeah, I think it was my freshman year, but it feels like so long ago, doesn't it?
It really does. Yeah. I'm going back thinking, that seems like it was like 4 or 5 years ago. There's no way Jared was still here at that point. But
definitely,
I think it was only 2 years ago. And then last year, you took down number 9 Hope. So, hey, it can happen again this
year.
Now, let's get into the final segment of the show. Jay Walt's called Brownie Bites. I'm going to ask you 3 off-the-wall questions. Give me your best answers.
All right.
Question number 1, which teammate is the owner of the worst football jersey?
I would have to say without a doubt, Colt North. He owns a Seahawks Russell Wilson jersey. And I don't think there's a worse jersey that I've seen so far. You know, J-Mo's Green Bay Packers jersey comes close. But I think that Colton's Seahawks jersey is probably the worst one.
What team do you find yourself rooting for the most?
Well, who's in the playoffs?
Okay, well, who's left? We have Saints, Rams, and we have Patriots, Chiefs.
Okay, so the winner of either one of those games, I'll get back to you, and I'll let you know who I'm rooting
basically
for.
Basically, so the winner of the Super Bowl, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to get let down when you always root for the winning team. So
I mean, you know? That's a good point and a good way to look at it, but unfortunately, you're wearing an Andy Dalton jersey, so.
Yeah, they didn't do too good this season, but, you know.
They haven't done too well for a long time.
Yeah.
So you might want to hide that for a little bit.
Sure.
Question number 2, which teammate would need the most energy drinks to get as hyped as you?
Yeah. I would have to say Charles Neal. I roomed with him for a year last year, and he, you know, I don't see him doing a Superman dive for a basketball on the court without a couple of energy drinks, a lot of caffeine in his system. I really don't see him doing that. I'm not saying he can't. I'm just saying I think he's going to need the most, you know, maybe 2 to 3 energy drinks to get him to that level.
He's so cool and he's calm. And you're right. He has the hustle. He would do it. Mm-hmm. But in order for him to, like, just regularly do what you do, I think he would probably have to drink so much caffeine it would be dangerous and start to develop, like, a little twitch.
Yeah, not a very healthy level of caffeine.
No, certainly something that Vic would not approve of in sports performance.
No, not at all.
No way. Then question number 3, if you could pick one teammate to take a trip on a yacht with, who would it be and why?
See, it's a tie between 2 people, but it's a tie between Colton and John. And the reason why it's a tie is because Colton, if I went with him, he would make me look better, you know? And so,
okay,
just the, you know, the abs and everything, like, you know, I've got him by a little bit. He's going to tell you otherwise, but, you know, but I think that I've got him there. But also John, another good friend of mine, you know, we do tend to take some good shirtless pictures, and, you know, so it's really good just to, you know, I mean, you gotta consider both things, you know. But I think John, I'd probably say John by just a little bit. But, you know, I live with Colton, so he's probably going to kill me when he sees this video, but, you know, it's all good.
Remember, Colton, your abs are not as good as Jared Wall. He said it, not me.
Yeah.
Those are not my words. Jay Wall, thanks for joining me on the show.
Sure.
I appreciate it.
I actually have a gift for you.
Oh, you do?
I do.
Oh, boy.
I brought it here, so hopefully you like it.
Oh, boy.
show the camera. It is a Superman jersey with my autograph on it.
Oh, you signed it?
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
So just,
this is wonderful.
Yeah, just wanted to say.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you for everything you do for the school and giving, you know, our athletes an opportunity to talk about themselves and talk about their lives outside of a, you know, outside of sports. And I think it's super awesome. So thank you.
Hey, you got it. Thank you very much. And this is going to be worn on the very next men's basketball broadcast at home, which, by the way, is going to be on the 31st of January when the Oaks bring in the Masters University top 10 ranked team in the NAIA. So thank you again, J-Wall.
Sure.
Much appreciated. And folks, be a reminder to tune in to the next episode of Unrooted Men's Basketball Edition. J-Wall is going to select the next interviewee by me, Brian Brownfield, right here on the show. Until then, we'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.